Switch it Dual Pro programming. Programming the Dual Pro head array takes place entirely on the back side of the center back pad. There is no need for a computer, programming interface, or any type of programming software. When the system is turned on, a single blue power light indicates that the head array is operational. In its normal operating mode, the entire back panel is locked out and the buttons will not respond to touch. To enter the programming mode, press Set and Force at the same time for 3 seconds until the left pad indicator light starts flashing. In this programming mode, the left pad can now be programmed. If Set is pressed again, the right pad starts flashing and is now programmable. Hitting Set a third time moves the programming functionality to the back pad, and a fourth hit returns the headrest to normal operating mode. In programming mode, a series of green lights may or may not appear in the crawl indicator, and red lights may or may not appear in the force indicator. Crawl senses the user's proximity to the pad. Once the user is in range, the proximity will activate at the speed percentage set on the Dual Pro. If there are no lights illuminated in the crawl indicator, the proximity sensors are disabled. Each time the crawl button is pressed, a light is added. If one light, the chair can reach 20% of its total speed using proximity. The second light 40%, the third light 60%, the fourth 80%, and the fifth 100%, assuming the chair is programmed to run at 100% speed. If the crawl button is pressed after all 5 lights are lit, the indicator cycles back to 0. Force is a measure of the user's head force against the sensor pad. As the force against the pad increases, the chair speed increases. If there are no lights in the force indicator, the force sensors are turned off. Each red indicator light equals the amount of force required to reach full speed. This is different than the proximity or crawl lights, which represent a percentage of total speed. If only one light is lit, it takes very little force to reach full speed. If all 5 are lit, it takes a significant amount of force to reach full speed. Utilizing all 5 lights also helps ensure a more gradual acceleration. Like crawl, force is set by pushing the force button in the programming mode. Each push adds a light until all 5 are lit. The next push cycles the settings back to 0. The more red lights that are lit, the more force required to reach 100% of the chair's speed. Any one of the 3 pads can be set to respond to only proximity, only force, or a combination of the two. So for instance, if the crawl is set to 3 lights and the force is set to 3 lights, the chair will achieve 60% of its speed using the proximity of the user's head to the pad and the remaining 40% by pressing against the pad with a moderate amount of force. This ability to control the chair using both proximity and force has some unique advantages. For example, take a patient in the early stages of ALS. They may be able to press against the pads to control the chair. However, as the disease progresses and they begin to lose strength in their neck muscles, they can simply move to a proximity-driven platform without changing to new equipment. Conversely, a spinal cord injury client may have a cervical collar which limits their range, requiring they start off using a full proximity setting. When the collar is removed and they gain range and strength, they would then be able to switch to a proportional setting through force, again, without changing equipment. A more complex example might be an individual who rests their head on the right pad and has difficulty moving it over to the left pad. In this case, the right pad could be set to 5 lights, or maximum force with no proximity or crawl. This would allow the individual to lightly rest their head against the right pad without moving the chair. If they press harder into the pad, the chair will turn right. The left pad could be set to proximity only, so the individual would only have to tilt their head to the left to initiate a turn. Probably the most popular setup is to set the proximity, or crawl, on level 2 and the force on level 3. This provides a nice mix of both proximity and force, so the user can easily move up to a 40% speed in a grocery store, office, or home setting. Once they are in a more open area, they can press into the head pads and achieve 100% speed without having to change profiles or modes. As the name suggests, the Dual Pro really does provide the best of both worlds.